Hey everybody, it's Matt with Mikey Designs and Silkscreen. And today I'm going to do a little tutorial on how to do spot colors in conjunction with CMYK process printing. And what I mean by that is I have a buddy of mine that needs a little help figuring out how to turn this blue and green into a spot color. He doesn't quite know how to pull out the image and separate that from the CMYK process image here. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do that. And to start off, I have the artwork in Illustrator, and I sized the artwork to size to the print size that it would actually print. So if I hit Command A to select it all, you'll see that it is set at 14 inches high by 10.25 inches wide. And what I'm gonna do is make sure my artboard is that same size, which it is, 10.25 inches wide by 14 inches tall. So we're good there. And you can see that the reason why we're doing this as a as four color process with a spot color is there's all these different tones going on that we just can't accomplish with a six color press is how we're setting this up. And but it's we've had a difficult time really getting this green and this blue here, so we're gonna go ahead and make those spot colors just so we make sure we get the colors correct, so that way the customer is happy. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this Illustrator document, and I'm gonna bring this into Photoshop. And what we're gonna do is open it at full size and at 300 dpi. There we go, here's our artwork. Okay, so you can see it's 10.25 inches wide by 14 at 300 dpi. And we're gonna open it in RGB color mode. Now that we've got our image open, we're gonna go ahead and flatten our image so that way we have a white background here to work with. And if you double click on your zoom tool here, that will give you 100% so you can actually take a look at the quality of the image that you're working with. And you can see here that everything looks pretty good, nice and sharp, so it should print really well. Initially, Gabriel wanted me to show him how to separate this image into three spot colors and CMYK process, but he only has a six color press. So we're just going to separate the blue and the green out. The red, I think, will come out fine as long as we have 100% yellow and 100% magenta. It should come out fairly red, and it's a small little piece anyway, so I wouldn't really worry about that too much. Okay, so first things first is we're gonna go ahead and separate this green here from the background. And how we're going to do that is go to select and color range, and we want our fuzziness between 100 and about 125. You might need some more just depending on you know, how many of the pixels within that color range it's pulling up. So I'm going to hit the dropper here, and I'm going to zoom in to my green, and I'm gonna go ahead and select the green here. And I'm gonna keep it at about 125 just to make sure it gets plenty of these green pixels here. We wanna make sure we grab some of these off green pixels as well, so that way there's no hard separation between the spot color and this magenta color here. So I'm gonna select some of these darker green. Excuse me, I need to go back, select this green, grab my plus dropper, select some of these darker pixels here, and then we're gonna go ahead and hit OK. So we've pretty much got all the green, and it looks pretty good. So what I'm going to go ahead and do now is I'm going to hit Command Shift and N. That would be control for you PC users. And we're going to title this green. Okay, and then I'm going to hit D on the keyboard. That will give us our default colors over here. And what I'm going to do is hold Option and hit Delete. And that will fill this area with black. And I'll show you in a little bit why we're doing that. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Command D to deselect that. And you can toggle this on and off and see that it even picked up some of the green here, which this will end up being a halftone, which is also something that we want. Okay. Now the next thing we're going to do, we're going to go back to our background color, and we're going to go back to select color range, and we're going to select our blue with our main eyedropper. We're going to select the blue here, and I think that should just about give us what we need. So we're going to hit OK. I'm going to zoom in and see what we got over here. So it looks like it picked it up pretty good. I'm going to zoom back out and hit Command Zero to make the image fit the screen. And then I'm going to make a new layer, Command Shift N. We're going to call this blue. Now we're going to hit D again to give us our default colors. And I'm going to hold Option and hit Delete. And now that will give us our blue spot color. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and turn both of these off. And since we got our blue and our green spot color, we need to go ahead and get rid of those out of our CMYK image. So I'm going to hold the Command button and hover over the little image window here. And I'm going to click, and that will give us our green. I'm going to hover over the blue, hold Shift. That'll give us that little plus sign right here, and I click that as well. So now we have both the blue and the green selected. I'm going to go down to the background layer here. I'm going to hold Command down and hit Delete, and that will fill that with white. And now our blue and our green is all filled in. Looks like we could probably expand that a little bit. You can still see some of the blue pixels here, so I'm going to hold the Command button down over the little image of the blue layer, and I'm going to do Select, Modify, Expand, and I'm going to expand that by one pixel. That should grab the rest of the blue pixels. I'm on my background layer. I'm going to hold Command, hit Delete so we can fill it with white. I'm going to hit Command D to deselect, and you can see all of our blue pixels are gone now. Okay. Now that we have that done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to image mode and turn this to the CMYK color. But before you do that, you need to make sure you have the proper color settings. If you go to edit color settings, you need to have a CMYK color setting that is meant for screen printing. And I got mine off the Ryanet website because it's free and tends to work pretty good for me. You can go to Ryanet's website and download those for free. I already have it loaded up. I like to use the IC Pro Bright profile because it works pretty good for my purposes. Okay, and so you go to image mode, and then CMYK, and we're going to hit Don't Flatten so we can retain our layers. Now that we've gotten that far, we're going to go ahead and save this as a PSD so we don't lose anything. Okay, and now we're going to go ahead and save a CMYK TIFF. So we're going to go to TIFF, turn off our layers, and we're going to embed, although some bread sounds good, maybe a sandwich right about now. So anyways, here we are. We've got our color profile clicked, and we're saving it as a TIFF, and we're going to title it CMYK. And I'm going to go ahead and hit Save. And I did this yesterday, but I didn't get a really get a chance to finish this. So I'm doing it all over. Kids were in the house running around. It was Labor Day, so we're going to go ahead and hit OK. So now we have our CMYK tiff. I'm going to turn off the background, and then I'm going to turn the blue on. And I'm going to hit Command-Shift-S to do Save As. And we're going to save this as a tiff. And we don't need the layers, and we don't need the color profile. And I'll show you why here in a moment. And I'm going to label this blue. Okay, and we're not going to save the transparency. We want it to be a flat image, and hit OK. And we're going to repeat that for the green. Command-Shift-S to save as. Save it as a tiff. Turn off the layers. We're going to call this green. We're going to hit save. And we don't want transparency. We're going to hit OK. So we're going to hit Command-W to close this. We're not going to save it because we already saved it. Now the next step is to open up this green and blue tiff. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn these to grayscale. So we're going to go to mode, grayscale. And we want to make sure that this is a full 100% black and white. If you go over to your info palette over here, you can see that it is 100% black. And so I'm going to hit, just in case yours isn't, you can hit Command L. And then take your black selector tool and then click in the black area and take the white and click in the white. And you can do that for just about any grayscale image. I'm going to hit save, Command S, and close this. And that comes in handy if you got a grayscale image, maybe a color image that you're just trying to turn to a black and white image. You can use that technique. So I'm going to go to this one and do it as well. Okay. And then I'm going to go ahead and save that and close it. One of the things I forgot to mention, I'm going to go ahead and go back to our CMYK tiff. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in. You can see there's black right here. And there's white. And one of the things you want to do is make sure it's a true black and a true white. So you want to go through and do that same routine by clicking the black and clicking the white. Essentially what that does is it gives you a rich black. If you were to print with just black and CMYK, it would come out to be about 90% gray. And if you look up here in the info palette, you can see that I've got some cyan, magenta, and yellow in there. And so that's what you call rich black. And you have all four of those colors layered on top of one another. So we looks like we're good there. And we're going to go ahead and hit save. And we're going to close this out. Now we're going to come over to Illustrator. And I'm going to open up my registration template, which you can download this registration template for free from my website at www.mikeydesigns.com. And up at the top, you'll see that there's a link to download that, just in case you want it. This is taking a moment here. Internet's running a little slow today. But here we go. So there's a registration template right there. So if you want it, you can go ahead and download that for free. So I'm going to click on my art layer, and I'm going to do File and Place. And I'm going to go back to our little folder here with all of our tiffs, and I'm going to go ahead and import all three of these, and we're going to keep it linked. And I'm just going to go ahead and click three times to place them all. Okay, and I'm going to select them all by clicking and dragging. I'm going to go to my line palette over here, make sure it says lined artboard, and I'm going to center that. And the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and assign some colors. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create my green spot color, and I'm going to give it 100% yellow, 100% cyan. I'm going to go to swatches. Excuse me, my phone going off there. So we've got our green. We're going to hit new swatch. We're going to call this green spot. And we're going to turn it to spot color. And we're going to hit OK. And you can see that's designated as a spot color here because it's got that little tab with the dot. And next, we're going to do our blue. So we'll just make it 100% cyan. So we'll call this, we'll call it blue spot as well. Make it a spot color. We're going to hit OK. So now we have our blue. Even though the blue and the green on my screen representation here they're not exactly the same color blue as they were in the document, but that doesn't really matter because you're going to designate that on press with the color blue that you want. So this is the blue right here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on my blue spot color. You can see it turn blue. Okay, and I'm going to hit transparency, multiply, and this is just so I can see the other colors below it. And I'm going to send this image to the back by hitting Command Shift and the left bracket. And I'm going to make this one green. And I'm going to hit multiply. Let's see, did I make that green? No, I sure didn't. Let's go ahead and designate that green. Let's see. Ah, I know what's going on. Okay, I don't believe I turned the green to grayscale. Yep, that's the problem right there. So now it's grayscale. I'm just going to go ahead and save it, close it, and it's going to update since it's linked. Okay, let's see, this is our green. Boom, there we go. And I'm going to, okay, so we got multiply there, and we're going to send this one to the back as well. I'm going to put our CMYK on, I'm going to go ahead and put all our images on a different layer. We'll call this one CMYK, we'll call this one blue, and we'll call this one green. And I'm just going to go ahead and quickly place all those images onto those layers. Let's see. Okay, this is our blue. I'm going to cut it, go to my blue layer, hit Command F to paste it in place. And now I'm going to grab the green, go to my green layer, hit Command F, which is paste in front. And it's going to paste it in the same exact spot that it was already in. Okay, so now we got all our colors here. And if you want, you could you can just turn the layers off and print each one individually. And what you'll want to do is go to output. And when you do the spot color, you can turn off all this process right here. That's one way to do it. Or you can turn them all on and then go to attributes here and click overprint fill. I'm going to select the blue, turn them all on, and I'm going to hit Command P for print. And if you went ahead and printed it like that, you would get six different pieces of film that would print, and that's about it. If you have any questions about this tutorial, feel free to contact me. Go to www.mykydesigns.com, and I have a tutorial on how to print CMYK process, and you'll just have to go there for the details on that. So, Gabriel, I hope this helps you out, and good luck with the project. And we'll see you guys next time.